Good morning, students.
Good morning, sir.
How are you?
Good, sir.
Students, today we are going to learn one of the important purification method of separation called simple distillation. The liquids which having difference in their boiling point vaporizes at different temperature. Do you know boiling point?
Yes, sir.
Good. Here you can see there are two liquids. This is the color liquid. This is colorless. This colored liquid is aniline. It is impure one. Look like reddish brown in color. This is the pure aniline. It is a colorless. This pure aniline we obtained from this impure one by this technique that is called simple distillation. Before we proceed to an experimental setup, we should learn the concept of simple distillation. So students, distillation is a physical process used to separate component from the mixture by the use of their difference in the boiling point. This is one of the oldest and most common technique used for the purification. Now, suppose we want to separate the two liquids, one of which vaporizes faster than the other. Once you heat the component, both the component, the liquids which having lower boiling point vaporize first and it condenses in the condenser. Once it is condensed, we can collect these vapors in the form of pure liquid in the receiving flask. This condensation process is on until least volatile substance boiled off completely. This technique is used frequently in the organic chemistry teaching labs. It is often used for the liquids which is relatively less contaminated and the liquids which having significant difference in their boiling points.
Sir, what is the meaning of significant difference in boiling points?
Significant difference in boiling point means their boiling point must have a gap between 20 to 25 degrees centigrade for both the liquids which we are distillating by this method. One another important point is separation of pure component from its non-volatile impurities or the substance which is dissolved in it.
Sir, what is the difference between volatile and non-volatile substances?
The substances which having relatively low boiling point and easily vaporize and thus they are considered as a volatile liquids. So students, for understanding the process of simple distillation or to carry out the distillation process, we need an assembly. This is a clamp stand. Now here this is clamp holder and this is hook clamp. A round bottom flask that is also called distillating flask. The capacity of distillating flask you can use around 100 to 500 ml. Here we have taken 500 ml. This round bottom flask or distillating flask is connected with a two-way adapter. This adapter connecting with Liebig condenser and this condenser again connected with receiving flask. In this condenser you are observing two outlets, rubber tubings are there. This is for inlet water supply and this is for outlet. For the heating purpose we need a heating device. Here we are using an electrical heating device and the device we can use in a controlled manner. The temperature required for distillation purpose we can control by using this. So let us start the process of simple distillation. But before starting, one precautionary note for you: carefully adjust the angle of adapter with condenser so that liquids should not come out here. Okay, now I am adding this impure sample of aniline to this distillation flask. I can use the funnel for the purpose. Here I am adding the aniline impure sample. After adding aniline, these are porcelain pieces. this should be added to the liquid. Okay? Before I initiate the heating to the liquid, Gaurav, please switch on the tape.
Sir, why are we using these porcelain chips?
Because we are using the organic solvents. If we will not use these porcelain chip, then solvent may bump out. The liquid may bump out from the flask. They will provide a certain surface for boiling. That's why we are using it. Now you can see that water is flowing properly through condenser. So let us initiate the process of distillation. Now, here you will observe the liquid vaporize, come in contact with this living condenser. Here you have added the cold water supply. This cold water supply condenses the vapors which is formed during the process, and these vapors condense in such a way that they will come to the receiving flask in the form of liquid. So observe carefully. Now look at the process. Heating is started. Now vapors are coming, and here vapors are condensing, and the condensing vapor converting to pure aniline. So here you can get the pure aniline. This was the impure sample, and we are getting here pure sample. So you have seen how this simple distillation process takes place. Now tell me that what you have learned today.
Sir, we have learned the principle of simple distillation and factors affecting volatility of liquids.
And sir, we had also understood the concept of boiling point and its relation to distillation.
Well done, student. So today's segment is concluded here. Till the next segment, goodbye.